Welcome back to Let's Play Rogue Legacy, the game I'm undoubtedly going to accidentally call Rogue Galaxy at some point. That is a very different game. In the last episode, we started the game. We made actually fairly decent progress. Let's see here. A mage with the axe, that sounds pretty good. Paladin with an axe. That would be a pretty tanky mage, but nah. Let's go with a mage with the axe. Kind of surprised I can even buy anything. How much is the knight chest plate? 525. Let's pump this into mana, I guess. Unfortunately, my mages aren't upgraded yet, so I don't get the well, they have a really useful ability. Let's leave it at that. So because I got hit so freaking early, this is going to be an exploration run. I figure if I can find a boss with relative ease and relatively little damage taken, I'll go ahead and give it a shot. With such wonderful displays as I've shown. Eh. Okay, this frame rate is really screwing with me. I have no idea why it's going. Died because I tried face tanking. A shinobi. Yeah, let's do it. Yeah, the mage's upgrade is to change between three spells. That is so good. The miner is really good because it lets you... Wow. The miner has the ability to... they get a lot more gold. I think they get like a 50% bonus? I ran out of MP really fast because I wasn't paying attention to that. You know what, let me cancel the rendering of the first episode. Yeah, that was definitely the issue. Oh yeah, there's a shortcut here because I have the dwarfism trait. Yeah, let's give it a shot. I've got pretty massive damage. Ow. And I dashed right into a bullet. Really? Let's see. Nave with quantum translocator, no thanks. Stereo blind is kind of fun. But I generally prefer Shinobi. Yeah, let's just give myself some more health. That really is my main concern. Although, in actuality, I should be focusing on, just whatever is cheapest. Do more damage if you manage to do the pogo stick jump consecutively, I think. That or that's just a perk. One lock. But that's a little too risky to me. And that one phases right through me. Ow. Oh, I still have the freaking curse one on. That's why I'm dying so badly. Tricked me, game. Ooh, an iron chest. That means either a ton of money or a new recipe, which is more likely. By the way, you unlock the blueprints and rooms in a linear order, I believe. Which admittedly does take kind of the variance out. You'll never get the knight chest plate before you get whatever comes before it. Okay, that did hit. To come back to that room when I have more MP. I might actually be able to do this. Nope. so 40 is one hit. What else do I have? Blade Wall and Fire Circle, which is another sustained spell. Not really great unless you're in like a boss fight or something. Oh, that was close. Oh, this is a real cluster of a room. All for a wooden chest? Are you kidding me? With another shinobi, I guess. Let's see. I'm going to need to start trying to take it a bit slower. Okay. That's an exit. Maybe. I'm not sure. Does your health recover between leaving and, somewhat? I'm just gonna go get some more mana, because that looks winnable for me. Okay. Ooh, that was dumb. Okay. Get slow. This is a room I very well might die in. Of course, that's technically every room except the very first room. Grace rune, I think that's the opposite of the curse rune. Makes enemies easier, but you get less money. There is no reason for me to be in here. Ow. So now I need to make a decision. Do I bum rush that mini boss? Or do I risk dying to maybe find more health? I think I'm gonna try and find more health. Okay. If I can at least get two blade walls. Which I have now. I might be good. But I need some insurance health. Wait, these guys made Bullet Odyssey? Was our very last game prior to working on Rogue Legacy. Being a bullet hell that was based on rhythm and beat charts, Bullet Odyssey was the most technically challenging game we had ever worked on. Yes, even more so than Rogue Legacy. Just to create a stage required three editors running in unison. Development for this game was also a little non-traditional, as a lot of pre-planning was required to make sure everything clicked. Being heavy advocates against documentation, this didn't settle well with us. So we had to talk out the whole game for like half a day. Why would you be against documentation? The game had the player absorbing enemy bullets in order to fire them back, and absorption happened on a beat which matched the song being played. Initial playtests were disastrous, as the game was too hard, and people became incredibly frustrated in the very first minute. By playtests, we mean one dude that doesn't even like bullet hells, but that's larger than our usual test pool. The game didn't perform very well when it released. That gave us the confidence to make Rogue Legacy. What? It didn't perform well, so it gave you confidence? Squire Cape. Money. Okay. That's a room. That's a room. I was looking to see if there were any, like, gateways. Okay, I'm a little more confident. I take out a couple more guys just to get a little more health. Maybe a smaller room? That's terrifying. No, I don't want knives instead of the blade wall. No! Oh. Let's see here. I really don't like this character. That's not any good. I guess I'll take the shinobi with an axe. It's actually not that useful. I'm gonna go for the miner. Trained more in the art of making money than killing enemies, miners are best used for scouring the castle for treasure chests and avoiding confrontation. Ooh, knave into assassin. I'm gonna go for crit chance up though. Whoa, what? Oh, the Neo ability. That's actually really cool. And we're actually going to see this layout if I ever decide to do boss rematches. Well, not layout, but this palette. Tile set. Tile set, this is an RPG maker. Hey, another journal entry. Journal entry number 2. Although I am the eldest child, I am not my father's favorite. I have always known he planned to leave me with nothing. But if I find the cure, everything will change. The victor will earn nothing less than the throne upon his passing. Upon my ascension, my wife and my children shall move back into the royal quarters, back to the royal city, where we once again will be treated with the respect we deserve. No longer will we stand for the gossip and petty slander of my cousins. The other dukes shall bow as we pass, but I am getting ahead of myself. I must keep my priorities clear. Conquer the castle, find the cure, collect my reward. Okay, it's this room again. Except hopefully with less die. Okay. Ah! Came out of nowhere. You're new and terrifying. Okay, retaliation rune. What do you think it does? When you get hit, your attacker takes a bit of damage, which also kills spikes. Well, the spike balls. So it's not that great, unless you're playing like a paladin. Not a paladin, a barbarian. Okay. Out of MP, but I killed a bunch of these guys, making that room a lot safer. I am not attempting the boss yet. Maybe if I find a bunch more health and mana, but not likely. I mean, I guess that could come in enemies I can kill without taking damage. I'm going to abuse rooms resetting, though. Not even sure if it's really an exploit. Okay, that was bad. Okay. Frig. Ow. I need a lot more health now. No chests immediately available there. The cool thing about the miner is you actually get to see where chests are before you go into the rooms with them. Which is really nice if you have the curse room. Oh, of course it was a chest and I died before I got to it. I'll take this. Upgrade nave would be no- wait. Do I need gold to gain up? That is super important. I don't think I really want to keep the cursor inactive though. Let's see, what was the one I got for my... Let's see, retaliation, grace room. I really want the vault room, but I don't think I have a balance room for anything else unlocked. What you really want to get is miners with dwarfism and or flexible. Flexible also lets you into the small passages, I believe. You haven't even unlocked the most interesting class, in my opinion, and the most fun. Believe me, that 10% gold gain is going to be a godsend. Especially when I get it up to 50%. I mean, granted it's going to cost a lot at the time, but... Actually, 50% is probably going to be only a New Game Plus if I decide to do that. which is pretty unlikely. I just kind of want to beat some games and be done with them at this point. Because I very rarely actually beat games. That's part of why I like being so much. Forgot how bad everyone else is with their damage. But I have a freaking ton of health. What? I thought you could stand on those. Is it like one pixel you can stand on? No immediate chests. Sorry, my throat's feeling a little dry. Probably because I recorded the last couple parts of Undertale today as well. Well, of the proper game. Oh, hey, a jukebox. We can actually have it play any theme from the game. Where is... There we go. I really like the boss theme in this game. Blood chestplate, that's the first piece of vampiric items. Piece of vampiric armor we've gotten. I really have no clue why I thought I'd go in here. Guess it was the blade wall. In fact, I think I want to pick up the blood chest plate. Yeah. It hurts your max health a bit, but it gives some armor, not as much as the knight stuff. And it gives you +1 vampirism. I guess I should get the cape as well. Oh yeah, this is what the stereo thing is. It's pretty dumb. And great. I mean, I might as well pick up the retaliation bracer room. I don't really like the grace room all that much because I much prefer getting money over not getting money. I do not enjoy killing people. That is like my least favorite thing to do. All right. plus one vampirism is really good. Okay. Really helps survivability. Don't think I don't see you. Skyrim, I don't remember what that does. Greetings, adventurer. I am here to give you a chance of a lifetime. With a measly sum of 25% of your current gold, I'll give you a chance to open one of three chests. One chest will triple what you paid, but the other two are empty. I'm gonna gather a bit more money before doing that. Okay, it's this again. There we go, and we get a gold chest. Ooh, plus two armor permanently for all characters. If you were wondering why anyone would actually do those rooms, well, now you know. Okay, that, I'll admit the dash is nice for that. You can also kill these things with your retaliation room. If you really think you have the health to spare. Ow, see? Night bracers. Good time to go back and gamble. Why did I do that? Middle. Oh, wow. Sweet. I didn't want to spend too much if I actually lost, so. That's the forest, that's the forest. What? Worth it. I'm doing really well for money this time. Okay, I do still have a little more exploration to do. Like, even if I'm pretty sure I will die, I'll go ahead and fight the boss if I fully explore the castle. Thank you for exploding, Mr. Spike Man. Blood Cape. No, don't do that. No, stop doing that. Why are you doing that, game? Really? Again. Whatever. Retaliate plus vampirism could be conceived as sort of like a defense up, I guess. Well, let's give it a failed attempt. A miner. Okay. Let's go ahead and upgrade weight to 100. Pick up the blood cape. The knave class into assassin. I mean, I don't really like that ability, but ooh, that might be good. Okay. Oh, I was thinking of the upgraded miner. Oh yeah, let's do this room with a miner. That's amazingly not the worst idea I've ever had, apparently. Okay. I'm gonna actually go for a boss run now. I figure I have the chakra, I have a lot of HP, let's look for a boss. I say a boss like we're gonna fight anything but Keter. We're off to a stellar start here. I love that the special for this class is basically a go away button. I don't like the special itself that much, but... Oh, right, this room. Hate that room. So much I barely remembered it existed. Right. Oh, I never even equipped the freaking floodgate. Whoops. Instead I have a 4% crit chance. I'm almost level. Oh no. Okay, this is actually terrible. There is actually something at the very top that requires you to have all of these barrels. In this room layout. Yep, there's access to a chest. I don't need to fight all of these Doomvises. I mean, it's a really good room to find. It's just kinda tough to get through. Yeah, I'll gamble. Well, that was awful. Wow, again. That would do more damage than it would heal, thank you. I shouldn't expect much better from the freaking 360 D-pad, though. this isn't quite the roguelike Metroidvania that people want Chasm to be. But I know, it's still a good game. It's freaking hard. But it's hard enough. Ooh, I made a mistake. I wonder if I can do it right the next time, if I have to. Kind of way. Ooh, I can get an item. Hermes boots. I want to say they work like in Terraria? Or I just jump higher? Not actually sure. Aha! This does. This is probably a terrible mistake. Oh, it just teleports you to a random point in the castle. Ah! I didn't expect to immediately run into Land of Darkness. Alright. Full on health, full on mana. I have chakrams, I'm a barbarian. Let's do this. Yep, wrong way. All right. Technically, it would have been better to kill him with a minor with the curse rune, but that wasn't gonna happen. All right, magic damage plus one, MP plus five, and weight plus five. All right. So that's one of the four bosses defeated. And we can actually do something with the boss doors here when we find them on future runs. I lack the skill to really take advantage of it. Because it gives you a specific setup. Wait, these are fake spikes? Eh, that fact wouldn't have helped me anyway. Ow. I mean, there's not much more I can accomplish on this run, I don't think. Oh no, is this, this is the one I think it is. This practically requires the vault room. Or even a couple of them. Oh yeah, you can land on the side of spikes just fine. I forgot. This is kind of an annoying layout to get to the forest, but the forest is going to be my main objective from here on. unless I roll a minor, in which case I want to go... The minor, you really want to clear out every area before moving on to the next.
Yep, I'm dead.
But hey, that's good progress for 2 hours of the game. So yeah, I actually do want the upgrade for the minor. Well, first of all, I want to get the Bloodgate. Not really important. Sky Rune. Okay, there we go. What's the Vault Room? Oh wait, yeah. Yeah, we can freaking fly. And you can use it just to delay your jumps. So I guess really I want to pick up Haggle. Haggle Man. Ooh, the Lich is fun. And crit damage up. Is there anything else I can buy? Alright. So next time on Let's Play Rogue Legacy, we're gonna head on through the castle again because I have a miner this one. But then we're going to go ahead and fight in the forest. See you guys then.